gon' be alright.
Hey, all things work together good.
We gon' be alright.
Tum-tum getting brought me on New England.
Good evening and welcome back, iMacin' friends. I'm glad that you all chose to join us today as we talk about fighting temptation. As Christians, we are tempted often, but we must stand strong in God's word so we won't fall into temptation. In Matthew 4, it shows us just how Jesus was tempted by Satan while he was in the wilderness for 40 days. Do you think that Jesus fell for Satan's tricks? Let's take a look at a short clip to see how Jesus handled himself.
Hey everybody, it's time for a Bible story. Today we'll be talking about when Satan, or the devil, tempted Jesus in the wilderness.
Jesus was talking to the devil, like the devil?
Yeah, that's the one. One day, the devil came to tempt Jesus. He wanted to trick Jesus into sinning.
Are you kidding me? The devil think he was just going to outsmart Jesus? He just wanted to trick Jesus?
Yeah, it's in the Bible. Jesus lived a perfect life, but he was human, just like you and me. So he was tempted to do things.
Huh, weird. All right, well, tell me the story then. Jesus was in the wilderness. What was he doing there? Like camping, napping, snacking, making s'mores by the fire, Jesus style?
No s'mores. Jesus was in the wilderness to be alone with God. He was there for 40 days praying and fasting.
Fasting? What's that? Like running super fast? Watch this. I bet Jesus was the fastest kid in his class.
What? No, I mean, I don't know. He was just a regular guy who also happened to be God. When the Bible says he was fasting, it means that he didn't eat any food for those 40 days.
No food for 40 days? That's like over a month. I can't even go like 40 minutes without food. Why would he do that?
Jesus was taking that time, the time you usually use to eat, to get closer to God and pray.
So now we know what Jesus was tempted to do. Tempted to eat some dinner.
After 40 days, the devil showed up in the wilderness and started talking to Jesus.
That's freaky.
It's okay. Jesus wasn't scared of him. The devil knew Jesus hadn't eaten any food for a long time, so he said to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, command these stones to become loaves of bread."
Ooh, man, love bread. Can Jesus do that?
He sure could. And he was really hungry. I bet bread sounded so good to him. But it was more important to him what the Bible says. So he told the devil no and used God's word to do it. He said, "The Bible says people should not live on bread alone, but by every word that God says."
Well, obviously you can't live on just bread, Hannah. You need pizza, cheeseburgers, mac and cheese, cake, ice cream, and a fruit.
Yes, a fruit is good. But that's not what he meant. He meant we can't survive with just food. We need the word of God, the Bible, to keep our spirits fed.
Ah, that makes sense. Well, good job, Jesus. You really showed him.
The devil wasn't done. He had another way to tempt Jesus.
Oh, no.
The devil took Jesus up to a really high place in the city and said to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, jump off this building because the Bible says God will tell his angels to protect you. They'll catch you with their hands so your foot won't even hit the ground."
Hold up. Why does he keep saying, "If you're the Son of God"? It's Jesus. Obviously, he's the Son of God.
Yes, but the devil is challenging him. It's kind of like he's saying, "Well, prove it."
Well, why doesn't Jesus just show him who's boss and proves it? If the Bible says angels will catch him, just jump off the roof and let him catch him. You know, if someone were to challenge me to do something I knew I could do, you bet I would do it.
Well, Jesus might have wanted to prove it, but the devil was trying to trick him into doing something he wasn't supposed to do.
But the devil said something that's in the Bible.
Like I said, he was trying to trick Jesus. So Jesus said no and told him, "The Bible says, do not put the Lord your God to the test." The devil was trying to trick Jesus into testing God. Yes, there are angels to protect us, but we aren't supposed to do something dangerous just to see if God is telling the truth.
Yeah, well, when you say it like that, it doesn't really seem like a good idea anymore.
Nope.
All right, Jesus, 2 for 2.
And the devil had one more temptation up his sleeve.
What now?
The devil took Jesus up to a tall mountain so he could see all the kingdoms of the world.
It must have been like a really tall mountain.
Then the devil said, "I will give all of this to you. All you have to do is bow down and worship me."
Ugh, gross. That sounds like a terrible idea. How would that even tempt Jesus?
Well, Jesus knew that the world did belong to the devil because Adam and Eve sinned. And there was a plan for Jesus to get it back, but it meant dying on the cross. So the devil was telling him, "If you do this, it would be all yours without you having to die." It's like, what would you do for $1 million? But instead, what would you do so you don't have to die on the cross?
Oh man, that one's kind of a toughie. Well, what did Jesus do?
Then Jesus said, "The Bible says, worship God only and only serve him." So the devil left. He couldn't get Jesus to sin.
Of course he couldn't. My boy Jesus can't put nothing on him.
Okay, that's enough of that. The end.
If you said no, that Jesus did not fall for Satan's tricks, then you were accurate. Jesus knew just how to react to Satan and did not give in. He stood strong in God's word and listened to his voice. Amen. At some point, you will be tempted to do things that you're not supposed to do, but never allow anyone to steer you away from God. If you hold fast to the word of God, then no one or no thing will be able to cause you to stumble. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for being here for us and never leaving our side. Give us wisdom to be able to handle temptation and protect us from those who don't mean us any good. We ask, Lord, that you will keep us close to you. Continue to lead us in the right direction. We thank you, Lord, and we love you. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Thank you all so much for joining us today. Make sure that you share this video with your family and friends and tune in every third Thursday for more Bible lessons. See you next time.